Several years ago, I was acquainted with an airline pilot here in the Denver area, and while I never had the opportunity to fly with them personally, several of my friends did. And without exception, they all said that he was exactly the kind of captain we first officers love to fly with. Technically competent, ran a great crew, fun on a layover. But did you know that airline pilots have to retire at a certain age?
Yeah.
Eventually, this career-ending limitation caught up with this guy. And he was required by law to hang up his captain's hat, you know, with scrambled eggs on the bill, his captain's coat with the four stripes on the sleeve. And at that point, he found himself standing on a watershed. And on this side of the watershed, leading up to retirement, he had been the quintessential airline pilot. It's all he ever wanted to do. It's all he'd ever done. In fact, his entire personality was wrapped up in this idea of flying big jets for United Airlines all over the world. But now, he was being challenged by fortune to look down the other side of the watershed and try to figure out how to be something else. Now, as I tell you this story, I think about Viktor Frankl's book, A Man's Search for Meaning. You know, in that book, Frankl suggests that life's not so much a quest for pleasure or power as it is a search for meaning. And I think about Friedrich Nietzsche, who tells us that one who has a why to live for can bear almost any how. This captain needed a why to live for. He needed a new why to help him bear his new how. He was facing a hard battle. Sadly, he chose not to fight it. The day after his retirement became official, he got his car, drove down to the fire station at Quebec and Dry Creek, parked his car, pulled out a gun, and created a permanent solution to what should have been a temporary situation in his life. And here's something I know about you tonight. Tonight, you are facing a hard battle. And daily, you are choosing to fight your battles or not. How's that going for you?